the guy we were dealing with, a brilliant marketing guy named Diego Scotti, said, I don't want to get into changing the logo. It's just too much trauma. I'm not into it. And so we sort of did this study, and the old logo consists of a modified version of Helvetica Bold Italic, where they've taken the Z and done this Mark of Zorro thing where it goes like, but that, and then further it starts out in, the rest of it is black and the Z is red, I think, and then it's sort of, and it fades out as it goes away. It's sort of, you know, has a, like a gradation in it, yeah, it sort of fades out, right? And then above it is a check mark. Or an angle, perhaps. I'm not sure what it is, like a big angle above it. And that also fades out. It has a gradation on either end, and it's much thinner. And so I've always thought that was the ugliest logo. I've always, long before my client called me, I sort of thought it was the most hideous logo I'd ever seen. Then he called me up, and to me it was like being a doctor, being with Doctors Without Borders, being asked to go someplace that had like Ebola virus. I'll be there tomorrow. When do you need me? I'll be there. And so what was funny was that, I actually respect them quite a bit as a company, particularly their... they're really getting their stuff together. I'm a Verizon customer, and I have to admit, I may be lucky, but way before I ever knew anyone there, I always have a really good customer service experience with them, unlike other people I deal with. So I was as passionate as one can be about a telecom service provider, which is minimally passionate. I think one thing that frustrates them, of course, is that people are really passionate about iPhones. You know, I love my iPhone. But your iPhone only works as good as the network that it's on. If it doesn't, if you don't have a network, it doesn't do most of the things you like about it. But no one cares. You know, people just get mad at the networks. You know, they don't say, wow, this network is so cool. You know, instead they say, I'm not getting enough bars or just people. And so telecom companies have a lot of challenges with that sort of thing. So they had a three-part... they gave us three words, or four words actually, but three-line kind of mission statement, which was simple, reliable, and for me, personal, right? Okay, so all I did was I took their logo, and we went out and photographed it all the different ways that it was, and it's like, for one thing, it's like really complicated. It has like Helvetica italic, and it has the hand-drawn Z for some reason, and it has like the thing up above it. So it's already complicated as opposed to being simple. Then, because it has these gradations, because it has these colors, you know, you can't reproduce gradations if you're making a die-cut sign. So they had a version of it that didn't have the gradations. Then people did other, then sometimes it was like, instead of doing the gradation, they had like the Z kind of get skinnier, so it looks like a rat's tail or something. So it was that version. We were able to kind of like put together a little dossier on the thing where there were 16 different versions of the logo, no two looking alike, right? So they claim to be reliable, except their logo looks different every time you see it. So it's and then finally, no one understands why the logo looks the way it does. No one at Verizon that we talked to can fully explain, but why? I guess the thing on top is supposed to be a V, but then the Z is why is the Z? Like, what does the Z have to do with anything? Speed. Z, the universal symbol for speed. I guess, yeah. Okay, if you say so, Stephanie, I buy it. Yeah. Energetic, lightning, right? But like, you know, the story I actually heard, which may or may not be true, was that when companies, it was a result of a merger, actually. And when companies merge, they have to start, if like, they want to announce the name of the new company when they announce the merger, but there are all these prohibitions about how the companies can meet before a merger is officially announced, and that comes from the Federal Trade Commission, and you know, it's sort of the people that govern big mergers, and so they asked a corporate identity firm to design a logo for them. They asked a naming firm to come up with a name. So the corporate identity firm said, do you have a name for it? They didn't have a name. Just design a logo. We don't know what the name is yet. Then they said, well, it might begin with a V or it might begin with a Z. They said, okay. Then the naming firm came, happened to come up with a word that had like a V and a Z in it. Meanwhile, the corporate identity firm had done all these things with Vs and Zs. They said, well, let's use that Z and that V and kind of put the rest of it. So it didn't, no one really understood what it meant, right? And so we just said, as an exercise, we just said, okay, what if we just do something and make it not complicated but simple, not inconsistent but reliable, and not incomprehensible but, you know, understandable, so for me. So it sort of hit each one of those things. And then we just did as an exercise, let's just kind of like relax this thing, set it in a nice, calm typeface, get rid rid of the Z, and then make that thing that people think might be a check mark, let's just make it a check mark. And so we just drew a check mark, put it there like that. So we thought all along that that was just a starting point, and then we would do clever things after that, like take the check mark and actually make it the V, or even put it over the dot on the I. And every time I did one of those clever things, it just sort of seemed like I was only doing it so if someone was ever to ask me in a situation like this, how'd you get that great idea for the Verizon logo? I would say, well, I was walking along and I just thought, wouldn't it be so cool if... And like I just thought, some things need to be clever and other things just need to do their job. And this is one where it's just a telecom logo, and I actually said, I don't think it should be that. I remember someone, when it was launched, someone said, the logo's like boring. And I said, I literally said, I just cured Ebola. And you say not throwing up and having diarrhea is boring. That's fine. Go puke and shit your guts out if you want, but I prefer being healthy, and I think this is a nice, clean, simple, healthy logo. So that was the story behind it, right? So it's not like there's anything, there's no mystery behind it. I actually became a fan when I started out, when I was much closer to your ages, I was really into kind of like making sure that everything I did had arrived with 1,000 pounds of cleverness loaded into it, just because I'm a clever, imaginative, creative person, and I need to demonstrate that every time I get asked a question, right? And then you look at something like the Target, or the Nike Swoosh, and those things are, the Nike Swoosh at least has fancy curves. The Target is like the stupidest answer to the question, what should the logo for this place look like? They got paid money, that was Unimark too, And, they said, well, here's a big idea, and they, it's a Target, get it? And it's like, okay, what? But think about what that simplicity has allowed, hundreds and thousands of people to do with that logo. The simplicity enabled all this creativity, right? And so I sort of, after having done a lot of like clever things, and some things, sometimes you do need a clever thing. We did a logo for a little bookstore on the Hamptons. We designed a logo for them that's super clever. It's going to be on coffee mugs and on dog, water dishes and on bookmarks and on the store. It doesn't have to, but like, Verizon has like lots of different agencies who have to manipulate that thing. And we didn't want to say, okay, this is simple. All you have to do is follow these like 32-part plan to deploy this logo. We wanted something like Verizon to check. Also, of course, like people know what a check mark is, right? It's like got that done, handled, And so we just wanted to look simple. And the same thing came up. We did, painful subject this week, but we did the logo for the Hillary Clinton campaign. And when that launched, people were just appalled. Because they were all used to Obama's logo, which has like lots of curves and sunrises and stuff in it. And I remember, much respect for that logo, which is brilliant. But I remember saying, given the way people communicate these days and the degree of participation we want people to have with the campaign, I want to design a logo that a 4-year-old can do with kindergarten scissors, construction paper, and a wooden ruler. Okay, I don't want people to need how to use like a Creative Suite 6 to do this logo. I want them to be able to do it like in the dark with their hands, they're blindfolded. I want it to be that simple. And when it launched, it just is this age with an arrow in it. And people were just like, what the hell? Like they just, everyone like hated it. But then I think over time, when it got, we knew all along, it was designed to have all these versions. So when we developed it originally, we also had, 50 different versions of it, and every, with the LGBT pride stripes in it, with different photographs in it, with different modified for different.
I never saw those. Did they have
them? Yeah, they're everywhere. Yeah.
I haven't seen all the variations though.
Has anyone seen any of those
variations? Oh, yeah.
Yeah. No, someone forwarded me this. But some, I mean, like, I can go. I'll go right there. I'll show you. Carved into pumpkins, cooked into pies, made into cookies. There's one woman. Social worker who was like every day made it out of something else. She made it out of folded laundry. She made it out of pieces of out of Cheerios at breakfast.